AWS Key Management Service, KMS, is used for creation and management of encryption keys. So firstly, there's something called the Customer Master Key, or a CMK. CMKs are the primary resources in KMS. They contain the key material used to encrypt and decrypt data. CMKs are created in KMS, and there's symmetric and asymmetric options. Symmetric CMKs and the private keys of the asymmetric CMKs will never leave KMS unencrypted. By default, KMS creates the key material for a CMK, but you can optionally supply the key material yourself from an external source as well. A CMK can encrypt data up to 4 kilobytes in size, and it can be used to generate, encrypt, and decrypt something called a data encryption key. Now, a data encryption key can be used for encrypting large amounts of data. So the CMK can only be used for up to 4 kilobytes. Anything larger than that, you want to use a DEK instead. Now, there are AWS managed CMKs as well as customer managed CMKs. The AWS managed CMKs are created, managed, and used on your behalf by an AWS service that's integrated with KMS. So for example, when we were in Amazon S3 and we enabled encryption using KMS, we didn't create our own key. We used an AWS managed key, so that already existed. You cannot manage these CMKs, you can't rotate them, and you can't change their key policies. They're managed for you, so you don't have that responsibility or that flexibility. You also can't use those AWS managed CMKs in encryption operations directly. The service uses them for you. Now let's look at data encryption keys. These are used when you want to encrypt large amounts of data, and you can also use them for encrypting other data encryption keys. As per the diagram here, you can use KMS CMKs to actually generate your plain text and encrypted data encryption keys. It's important to understand that KMS does not store, manage, or track these data keys, and it does not perform any cryptographic operations using those data keys. So that's something that you need to do then, so you can build that into your application. And therefore, you're actually using and managing your data keys outside of KMS. Finally, let's compare the different types of customer master key. So there's three, the last one I didn't mention before. Firstly, there's the customer managed CMK. For these, you can view them, manage them, they're used only in your account, and you can optionally enable rotation every 365 days. The AWS managed CMK is viewable, but you can't manage it. It is only used for your account, and the automatic rotation is actually required, and it's every 1,095 days. Lastly, there's the AWS owned CMKs. You don't see these, you don't manage them, and they're used across different accounts, and the rotation varies. You really don't see these at all, so they're not really a concern for the exam. The key things to understand are the differences between the customer managed CMK and the AWS managed CMK. I'm on the KMS console here. Now on the left, you can see that there's AWS managed keys. And under there, we can see some of the keys associated with the services with which we've enabled encryption so far as we've been going through the course. And you'll see additional ones appear here when you use more services. So these are the ones that are managed by AWS, and you actually get to use them via that service. AWS performs all the cryptographic operations. So you don't have any control over them, but they're extremely useful. Then we have the customer managed keys. Now we've got one here, and that's because when we enable CloudTrail, we wanted to encrypt the contents of our log files. So that key already exists. And as you can see, it's a symmetric key. Now let's try and create our own key. Now you have the option here of creating symmetric or asymmetric keys. Let's create a symmetric key. If we expand advanced options, you can see that we can either allow KMS to create the key material, or we can choose an external source or a cloud HSM key store. We'll talk about cloud HSM in another lesson. For this lesson, we'll use KMS. And you can change the regionality if you want as well. I just need this in a single region, so I'll leave it as it is. Click on next. We'll give it a name. Optionally, you can add a description and tag it if you want to as well. I'm going to click on next. Now, there are two different types of permissions that we can assign to our keys. First is the administrative permissions, and then we've got the usage permissions. So who can administer the key and who can actually use the key? And those can be different parties if you want to separate those permissions in your organization. Now, let's say I just want to choose my user account, Neil. So I'm going to be a key administrator. And now I can delete the key as well if this option is selected. Let's click on next. Now we have the usage permissions. So let's choose my account again. You can also add other accounts to be able to use the key. Click on next. We now get to the final screen. And if we scroll down, you can see what it's done is created this policy. And in the policy, you can see we've enabled IAM user permissions for the root account. That's always going to be there. That allows all actions on KMS. Then there's the specific administrative permissions under key administrators, and that's the ARN for my user account. And then I get some specific actions for administering the keys, KMS create, describe, enable, list, and so on. Scrolling down a bit further, we've then got the usage of the keys. So again, it's the ARN for my user account. And here we have the actual usage permissions. So KMS encrypt and decrypt and re-encrypt and so on. And lastly, there's the allow attachment of persistent resources, which is these grants and list grants and revoke grant. So all of that looks good. Let's just create our key by clicking on finish. So there we go. We've got a key that we could now use for encryption and decryption. Now, if I click on the key alias, you'll then see that you've got the key policy here. So as you can see, you can actually edit this. You can change the permissions that are assigned both for the key administrators and the key users as well. Coming back up, we've then got the cryptographic configuration. We can't change anything there, any tags and rotation. So if we want to rotate our key automatically every year, we just enable that option here. You can also create additional aliases for your key as well. Now what I'm going to do is go back up to the top level, and I don't need this key. So let's have a look at how we can delete keys. Of course, in the real world, you want to be super careful about deleting encryption keys. If you've encrypted data with it, you might not ever be able to decrypt that data again, so it's lost. So therefore, there is an option to schedule key deletion. You can't just delete the key. You can disable it and then it can't be used, but it can always be enabled again. But with scheduled key deletion, you can have a waiting period from 7 to 30 days. So I might put in 7 days here. And that means that within that 7 days period, if I realize that I've made a big mistake, I can come back and I can recover my key. After 7 days though, it is gone forever. So I'm going to confirm that I want to schedule the deletion of this key after 7 days, and then just choose schedule deletion. And that will now happen automatically for you.